Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through rigorous 2PL guys. In the previous tutorial, we have gone through static 2PL, right? Okay, so in this tutorial, we'll be going through rigorous 2PL. So basically, rigorous 2PL will help us in recovering, but we are facing the same problem which we have faced in the basic 2PL, that is nothing but deadlock will be coming back in this rigorous 2PL. So goal of removing dirty read, that is nothing but recovering the data, is possible here. So what is dirty read? So if you write the data and if you forget to commit and if you read the data, that is nothing but dirty read. So you may ask me that what is dirty write then? So dirty write is nothing but without reading the data, if you try to write the data, that is nothing but some garbage values or some random values, that is nothing but your dirty write. Fine. Okay, so here this is a situation where dirty read comes into play. Okay, so basically how we can rectify this dirty read? Okay, so basically we will be using the concept of commit. Fine, I hope everyone knows the meaning of commit. Commit is nothing but saving till what we have did till now. So once you write after some transitions, if you write commit, it will save till there. Fine. Okay, so that is the reason why here we will be having only the growing phase till lock point. After that, automatically according to our requirement, we will be unlocking the locks. Fine. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this guys. So initially we will be applying the locks according to our requirement, but there is no need of unlocking them. Once the transaction completes, or once the requirement of that is completed, it automatically commits. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. Okay, so now let us go through the theory. It is an improvement over 2PL. So this could be an updated version of 2PL protocol, where when we try to ensure recoverability and cascadable rollback. So we are trying to ensure these things. So in rigorous 2PL, we require that all the locks must be held until the transaction is committed. Yeah, that's what I told. Once the transaction completes, then it commits and then it unlocks. In that way, it is going to happen. Fine. So that's the reason why we are not having any shrinking phase in the life of this transaction. So recoverability and cascadable rollback will be achieved, but there is really a high chance of deadlock. And this process is completely inefficient guys. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, okay, if you want a small example, just write here commit guys, that's it. That's the main change. Then you can say that it is in rigorous 2PL, fine. Okay, so in the next tutorial, we'll be going through we have already discussed about static guys, this is strict 2PL. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through strict 2PL. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.